गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
दैट्स गुड मॉर्निंग। गुड मॉर्निंग। ओके सर, विदाउट एनी डिले आई एम स्टार्टिंग राइट, बिकॉज़ दिस इज जस्ट द डिस्कशन क्लास, ओके, ऑन दोस टॉपिक ऑफ मोर इम्पोर्टेंस। ओके, सो जस्ट लेट मी शेयर द स्क्रीन। फर्स्ट वी विल डिस्कस द एमसीक्यूज ऑफ प्रीवियस ईयर। Okay, then I will solve your query. If you have any doubt on any topic or any particular portion of a system, okay. So first we will solve the previous year question. Okay, 2019 and 2020 paper I already MCQ, all the MCQs were already solved, right? Okay, check. Is the screen visible?
No, sir.
It is not visible.
No, sir.
Okay. 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 Fine.
Just. Not visible, sir.
Okay, check now. Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Visible.
Okay. Fine. So the first question that you can see here, that is an alternating. Okay, just let me zoom in. Okay, choose the correct alternatives of any five following. Okay, so this is the first question that was given. Okay, the question was an alternating current completes 5 cycle in 8 millisecond, the frequency of the current. Okay, now tell me how to solve it. It is given 5 cycle in 8 millisecond. So how to calculate the frequency?
First we will calculate for 1 cycle.
Yes.
So first we'll calculate for 1 cycle and then time period is equals to 1 by frequency is equals to 1 by time period, we'll do it.
Exactly right. So 5 cycle, it current, this alternating current completes 5 cycle in 8 millisecond, that means 1 cycle in 8 by 5 millisecond. Okay, so 8 by 5 millisecond means 1.6 millisecond. Okay, so it completes the 1 cycle in 1.6, is it right? 1.6 millisecond. Okay, now this is the total time period you got. So what is the frequency? Frequency is nothing but 1 by t. Okay, so now it's very easy to calculate, right? Now check which value you are getting. This is almost 6 to 5 hertz, I think. Is the answer D after calculation? Okay, let me calculate. I have the calculator right now.
Yes, sir, 625.
625, na? Okay, good. So the answer is 625. This is the right answer. Next, if a circuit does not contain any source of energy or EMF, it is known as which kind of circuit? Okay, who is present now? Okay, if the circuit does not contain any source of energy or EMF, then it is known as what? Active network, passive network, bilateral or unilateral? Which one?
Passive network.
Because see, what is bilateral circuit? Bilateral circuit will only be applied for resistance, inductor and capacitor. Okay. And unilateral circuit means there must be one diode or such kind of device that controls the flow of current in a particular one direction, right? So that is the correct answer here will be passive network. Next, for a coil with n turns, the self inductance will be proportional to okay, who is present? Okay, right. So tell me which value will be this one? The coil number of eight. Yes? Which one?
E.
A. How you are saying this, that this answer is A?
The induced EMF N into d phi by dt.
Okay. But the self-inductance, if you calculate the formula, okay, the self-inductance has a particular formula. Okay. If you calculate the self-inductance formula, then you will see that this value is not what you see here. Okay, the L value is actually this one. If you calculate L value, that means the inductor value is mu 0 n square L by A. Okay, this value is mu 0 n square L by A. Right, okay, no, sorry, that is not L by A, that is A by L. Okay, let me correct it. That value is basically mu 0 n square L, mu 0 n square, what was the previous one? That must be opposite. Yes, that is, that will be A by L. Okay, that will be A by L. This is the actual equation of the inductor. Okay, that is the self-inductance. Clear? So from here, mu 0, that is constant for a particular medium, right? A length, area, if it is constant, then I can say that it is directly proportional to N square. So correct answer is B. Okay, next, in a phasor diagram of, okay, is there any query? Okay, fine. Now, in a phasor diagram of two phasors, the ratio of their frequencies should be, see, in a phasor diagram of two phasors, their ratio of their frequency, the frequency of two phasors, that is always 1. Okay, why? Because, see, this is the voltage, okay, so this is the phasor of the voltage, because it is starting from 0, right? Now, another frequency, another voltage that is started after, suppose 20 degree or 10 degree, okay, but the frequency is always same. Clear? So it is lagging, but their frequency is always same, right? So the answer is always 1 here. Now, next one, the voltage applied across the 230 volt 60 watt lamp is reduced to 115 volt. The power consumed at this reduced voltage is, now this one is easy. Now I am giving this question to you to answer. Okay, tell me how to solve it. This one is easy.
First we'll find V square by R in by V square by R.
Okay, fine, good. Yes, I got your point. So that means here 60 watt is given. Okay, so from 60 watt 230 volt square divided by R. So first here you will find out the R value. Okay, next R value is known. So R 115 square equals to how much loss, right? But just by looking, how will you calculate? See, if your voltage here is reduced, okay, the reduction fraction is always getting twice. Look here, it is 230 volt, okay, voltage is always square here while calculating the power. Okay, so if the voltage is reduced half time, if the voltage is reduced by 0.5 times, then how the power will be reduced? It is nothing but the square of the half, right? So your latest power or your reduced power will be 60 into 1 by 2 square. That means 15. Okay. Is the concept clear? If you do this process, if you do like this, you will get the same value. No change will be there, but you need to save your time since you have short time at hand. Right. How will you check? Here, 230 volt is given, right? And the voltage is reduced to 115. So how many times is your reduction? That is half, 1/2 times, right? And see, the power is depending on voltage in square manner. So if your voltage is reducing, if your voltage is reducing 1/2 times, then your power will be reduced 1/2 whole square times. That means 1/4. That means here ultimate reduced power consumption is 15 watt. Is it clear? Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, next one. Two unequal resistances when connected in series giving a value of 10 ohm and when connected in parallel giving a value of 2.4 ohm. Now the value of resistances are, how will you calculate it? R1 and R2, okay? R1 and R2 are two resistances. So if you connected them in series, this value will be 10, okay? And when you connected these resistances in parallel, that means R1, R2 divided by R1 plus R2, okay? So this value is nothing but 2.4, right? So here, R1 and R2 value is 10, that is already known to you. So I can write here that R1 into R2 equals to 24, right? So now check in between them which answer is satisfying. That is R1 plus R2 equals to 10 and R1 R2 equals to 24. Okay, R1 plus R2, 10.
A.
Option A, right? Because 6 into 4, that is 24. Okay, so option A is your right. Next, the time constant in RC series circuit is equal to, always remember, when you calculate the time constant, okay, if you, do you remember anyone?
Sir, RC.
The time constant for RL circuit is always, it is written as tau, okay, that is L by R, okay, and if you check the RC circuit, that will be RC, okay. Okay, now next one is the, what is the lifting power? Okay, it is not in your syllabus, so no need to worry. Okay, this one is very good question, okay, for you. Look, The circuit takes a current of 4 ampere at 200 volt. Okay. A current leads the applied voltage by 30 degree. Okay. Find the circuit parameters and draw the impedance triangle. So how will you do that? Okay. We just need 3 minutes to solve it. How? See, the circuit takes the current of 4 ampere at 200 volt, and it is told already that current leads the applied voltage by 30 degree. So if I put the voltage as your reference, okay, so this is your 200 and current is leading, okay, this is your current I, value is 4. Okay, how much is your angle? 30 degrees, right? So if you calculate V by I, what value you will get? This is AC circuit, obviously, otherwise no lagging leading concept will be there. So this V by I will be equals to Z, right? Okay, so what is the value of V? That is 200. What is the value of I? That is 4, but angle is also present. So angle is your 30 degree, right? If you do not understand at any point, tell me, right? Now, 50 angle minus 30. Okay, next. So this is the Z value. So Z value, that is your impedance value, is 50 angle minus 30. Clear? So 50 angle minus 30, it means the circuit is consisted of a resistor and one capacitor. Because see, the Z value is minus 30 degree. So check, because I know already that Z cos theta equals to R. Okay, so 50 into cos 30. Okay, so the value is 50 into cos 30. What is the value of cos 30? That is root 3 by 2. Okay, so that is 25 into root 3. Next, Z sin theta. This is the value of the reactance. Z sin theta, right? So Z sin theta equals to your value of X. So this value is minus, because sin theta means it is minus 30 degree. So it is half. So ultimate value is 25. So what is your impedance triangle now? This is your R. Okay, and this is your XC, because this value is minus 25, right? So this is your Z value. So this is your impedance triangle. This is your Z value. The angle is minus 30 degree. That is already known to you. Okay. Is the calculation clear? Or any confusion is still persisting? Is it okay? Should I move to the next?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, see this circuit. For the circuit shown below, the potential difference between A and D. How will you calculate it? See, here one loop is present, here one loop is also present. But in this line, there is no loop. Okay, so how will I calculate it? Right. See. Suppose one current is flowing, okay, you need to apply what? Mesh analysis. Next, another current is also flowing, right? Use your mesh analysis. So from this first I1, so what is the value of I1? Can you calculate? What is the value of I1? Please calculate. That is 3 by 4, isn't it? 3 by 4. That means 0.75. Okay. So if 3 by 4 is ampere is flowing, so what is the potential drop across this point? Suppose this point I am naming as X, I am naming this point as Y. So what is the voltage across this AX? Can you tell me? Voltage AX. See, only multiply 2, na? Why are you sitting idle? That is
6 by 4, 2 by 3.
3 by 2, not 2 by 3. That is 3 by 2 volt.
Yes,
okay.
Yes.
Which side is plus, which side is minus? Which side is plus, which side is minus?
Sir, A is plus and X is minus.
Very good. A is plus, X is minus. Because the current flowing in this direction. Okay. And when a current flows from one direction to another, then the first point will always be positive and the following point will always be negative. Okay, so this point you got. Clear? Now, calculate the voltage here also. Calculate the current here. Suppose this current is I2. Okay, what is the value of I2? Tell me.
2.5 ampere.
1 by 2.
Yes?
So
0.5 ampere. So here the current is I2, the current is your 0.5 ampere, but the direction is opposite, isn't it? The direction here will be minus, because look, if you do the mesh analysis here, the current will flow through this 5, through this 5, okay? So it will be minus 10 I2, right? And when the current is flowing through this voltage source, it is passing from positive to negative, isn't it? That means your potential is dropping. So I will write here minus 5 equals to 0, right? So I2 value is what? I2 value is minus 0.5. Clear? So if I2 is minus 0.5, then I will correct my drawing here. I will correct my drawing here. So your I2 flow here is like this. Okay, then only you can say that your current is 0.5 ampere with positive sign. Okay, so when current is flowing in this direction through 5 ohm, some potential drop will be there, right? What is the amount? The amount is 2.5 volt, isn't it? Please check V, Y, D. Value is 2.5 volt. Clear? Or any confusion is still there?
Clear, sir.
Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
So which point is positive? This point is positive. This point is negative. Right? Clear? Okay. So now I will calculate VAD. VAD. Clear? So now look, VAD equals to VAX, okay, plus VXY plus VYD. Okay, now what is the voltage of VAX? That is your 3 by 2. Okay, next, XY, this voltage is minus 2 volt because see, here it is minus and plus. Next, VYD, VYD means again, it is what? Addition of 2.5. Okay, so the answer is C. 3 by 2 means 1.5, 1.5 plus 2.5 means 4, so 4 minus 2 is 2 volt. So that is your correct answer. Okay, so that is this 2 volt is your correct answer. Next, derive the expression for average value and RMS value. This one is okay, I think, because this waveform is repeating after pi. So only you have to draw, only your equation will be V omega t equals to Vm sine omega t, okay, and your timing will be 0 to pi. Okay, this is your omega t. Omega t equals to here 0 to pi. And what is your total time period here? Total time period here is also pi. Because see, after pi, it is again repeating. After 2 pi, it is repeating again. So here your total time period is pi. Clear? Now this one is the find the current through the resistance RL. So this one is not needed actually, I think. Okay, since you are having only 1 mark and 2 marks questions, so no need to discuss all these lengthy questions. Okay, so I am moving to the 2017 page. See, here one question is given. In order that a DC generator be able to excite and generate voltage, the value of the field winding resistance, it should be less than the critical value. Okay. It must be less than the critical value. The critical value of resistance means, the critical value of resistance means that it is the maximum value of resistance if you apply. Why it is? Okay, so here it is the less than the critical value, because critical value means it is the maximum amount of value of that resistance, maximum amount of value of the shunt field resistance before, that means above which your excitation will not work. Okay, your EMF will not be generated. That is the critical value. Okay. Next, in the direction of current, Following, a conductor is in the plane of the paper, the magnetic flux line by it, R. That means, if the direction of current following in a conductor is in the plane of the paper, that means suppose this is your paper, okay, you have placed one conductor and one current is flowing. Okay, so how the flux, magnetic flux lines will be there? Okay, it will be like your right hand corkscrew rule. Okay, right hand corkscrew rule means if this is your current direction, then this is your flow of the magnetic flux lines. So if your current is flowing through like this, then your current will be this kind, that means your clockwise direction. Okay, so your lines will be in clockwise direction, right? Because you have to remember here the right hand corkscrew rule. Okay, if this is your direction of current, if the thumb represents the direction of current, then this kind of rotation will show you the magnetic lines of force. Okay, here the current is placed on the paper, so current is flowing in this direction and your rotation of magnetic lines will be like this. Okay, so that means the clockwise rotation, a concentric circles with clockwise rotation. Next, in a transformer, the flux phasor, this was already discussed, because the flux is always linked with primary and secondary. That's why we put the flux in reference always. Okay. Then with respect to reference, this is your primary voltage. This is your primary voltage. Right, and this is your secondary voltage. Okay, sorry, this is your secondary voltage. That means in the transformer, the flux phasor, this is your flux phasor, that is phi. Okay, now it leads the induced EMF by 90 degree or lags the induced EMF by 90 degrees. So this one you have to decide. Okay. Now how will you say that? This is your V1. Okay. And when you calculate the E1, that will be always in negative direction. Why? Because of the Lenz's law. Okay. That is E equals to minus of N into d phi by dt. Right, so that's why V1 will be placed in positive y axis and E1 will be placed in minus y axis. Clear? So here we can say that the flux phasor will always lead the induced EMF by 90 degree. Okay, for the ideal case. Okay. Is there any confusion in this question or should I move forward? Any problem or should I move?
No, sir, no problem.
Okay, fine. Next, when the phase sequence, okay, listen, if you have any kind of problem when I discuss, please tell me, okay, because we have very short time. Now, when the phase sequence of a three-phase sinusoidal system is stated as A, B, C, it implies what? It implies, first draw this one. This is your phase A. Okay. This is your phase B. Right? This is your phase C. So now, this is the lagged 120 degree. Right, this is, I think this is known to you, this is three phase system. So based on this diagram, which one is correct? Okay, let's check one by one. See, the phase voltage A leads the phase voltage B by 120 degree. Is it correct? See, phase voltage A leads the phase voltage B by 120 degree. Yes, it is correct, because if you choose B, then A is 120 degree leading. So A is correct. Fine. Next, let's see. Phase voltage A lags the phase voltage C by 120 degree. Now see here, it is also 120 degree, right? It is also 120 degree. Now this one is positive, this one is negative. That means what? C is basically leading by angle 120 degree with respect to A, right? So I can restate this as A is lagging with respect to C by angle 120 degree, because see, A is basically lagging with respect to C. Okay, by how much angle? 120 degree. So B is also correct. Similarly, phase voltage B leads the phase voltage C by 120 degree. So that is also correct, isn't it? So ultimately your answer will be all of these. Clear? Next, question number 5. Okay, is this question clear? Question number 4, is it okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Next, question number 5. In the measurement of three phase power by 2 wattmeter method, if the 2 wattmeter readings are equal, then the power factor of the circuit. See, this question is based on your lab experiment. Okay. I hope, I don't know whether you remember it or not. That is tan theta equals to root 3 into P1 minus P2 divided by P1 plus P2. This equation was there, from where we calculate the theta value. Okay, so here what is given? 2 wattmeter readings are equal. So if that is equal, that means what? P1 minus P2, this value equals to 0. So what you are now getting, tan theta, why my mouse is giving me so much trouble. See, tan theta equals to then 0. So theta value is 0. So cos theta equals to 1. So your power factor of the circuit is, the power factor of the circuit is always unity. Okay, so that's how you need to solve it. Basically, what you need to remember this equation, that is tan theta equals to root 3 into P1 minus P2 divided by P1 plus P2. Okay, now next one is, the capacitance of the capacitor is not influenced by, see, this capacitance of the capacitor is not influenced by. So now you have to recapitulate the equation of the capacitor. The equation of the capacitance, that is C equals to epsilon A by D. Do you recognize this equation? Okay, so now tell me which option is correct.
Thickness, plate thickness.
Plate thickness. Because if you take 2 plates, suppose this is 1 plate, okay, this is 1 plate, and this is another plate. Okay, so whatever be the thickness of this plate, whether it is 1 millimeter or 2 millimeter, it doesn't matter at any time. What matters? The plate area. This plate area, this one matters. Okay. What is epsilon? The medium in between this section. Right. So plate separation matters. Plate area, it also matters. And nature of dielectric, yes, obviously, it will matter. Okay. So plate thickness is the correct answer here.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, one more formula is there, sir. C is equals to epsilon naught A by D minus T, sir. Your thickness is applied, sir. T.
Yes, but it will only be possible, that is D minus T. D minus T. For which kind of case? That is T, that is not the thickness.
Sir, dielectric is placed in plate, sir.
No. Nature of dielectric strength, it will be given by this epsilon. Okay. What he is asking, that is D minus T or D minus A, that kind of formula was also there. But if you look, that T is not thickness, that is the separation. Okay. That is the separation. Suppose that means this is one capacitor. Okay. Now, I am moving this capacitor in this way. So, how much distance is traveled? That will be given by T. That is not thickness at all. Okay.
Yes, okay.
Okay, fine. So, is there any short question? Okay, do not forget that open circuit test. We did open circuit test of single phase transformer to calculate, to have the core loss or iron loss. Okay, they are basically same, core loss or iron loss. Okay, it is consisted of two kinds of losses, hysteresis loss. Another one is eddy current loss. Okay. From short circuit, we calculate the copper loss. Do not forget this one at any time. Okay. So here look, this wattage value that you can see from the wattmeter, 75 watt. It gives you iron loss. Okay. Short circuit test, this wattage value 60 watt. It is the short circuit loss. That means it is the copper loss. Okay. Now, hysteresis loss, this cannot be minimized. This one is constant, but we can minimize the eddy current loss by using the laminated core. Okay, only core lamination is the finest process by which we can minimize the eddy current loss of a transformer. Do not forget that. Okay, and from here there is no such question. Okay, now if you have any kind of topic that you think you need to discuss, you can say.
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, please discuss the question of module 3.4, question number 1.
Yes, please tell again.
Sir, module 3.4, question number 1.
Module 3.4, question number 1. Okay, just a minute. Then I have to open it. Okay. Module 3.4, question number 1. Okay, just a minute. Question number 1. Okay. Let me share the screen here. Okay, is the screen visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. See, here it is said that a single phase transformer takes 10 ampere at no load at power factor 0.2 lagging. Okay, that means this 10 ampere that you have in hand is your no load current. I am naming it as I0. I hope there is no problem here. Okay. Now, the turns ratio is 4:1. It is step down. Clear? So, what is your turn ratio? K equals to 1/4. Is that okay? Is that okay?
So, why 4, sir?
Yes. See, what is the turn ratio? I told you, no, that turn ratio basically means V2 voltage by V1, right? And since voltage is directly proportional to the number of turn, so I can say this value is N2 by N1. So that I can say this value is 1/4. Is that clear now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, good. Now, if the load on the secondary 200 ampere power factor 0.85 lagging, find the primary current and the power factor. Okay. So, how can you calculate it? First, try to draw the phasor diagram. Okay, then only it will be so much simplified. How will I show you? This is your flux phi. Okay. This is your V that is in positive y axis. Clear? And the secondary load is, load current is already told as 200 ampere. Okay. Now this one is your secondary voltage. This is your primary voltage, that is V1. Okay, and no load current is said as 0.2 power factor lagging. That means here cos theta 0 is 0.2. Is it okay?
Yes.
So what is the value of theta 0? Can you tell me? What is the value of theta 0?
Cos inverse 0.2.
Cos inverse 0.2.
Yes, please tell me the answer that is already given here. Look, 78.5 degree lagging. Okay, clear? 78.5 degree lagging. So that means the value is almost like this. That is your I0, isn't it? Because here the power factor is calculated on which basis? That is the angle between voltage and current, isn't it? So here, look, the voltage is V1 in primary, obviously. And no load current is flowing through the primary also, right? So this angle is your theta 0, or here it is written as phi 0, no problem. Okay, so I0 now you have. Clear? Next, this is your V2, that is secondary. Okay, it is said that the secondary current is 200 ampere at 0.85 lagging. So this is your 200 ampere. Suppose I am drawing here. This is 200 ampere. 0.85 lagging. So this is the angle for secondary. Is it clear? Because what is power factor? That is the angle between the secondary voltage and secondary current. Okay. So this is your secondary voltage. This is your secondary current that is given as how much? 200 ampere. Okay. So now what we need to do? We need to check that for what primary current I am getting the secondary current. That means I1 dash. Okay, so I am drawing here, or you can say it as I2 dash as per your need. Okay, so I am writing here as I2 dash. Okay, what is the value? The value is 4 ampere. Okay, no, it is not 4, so it is 25 almost, I think. 50 ampere, sorry. That is basically 50 ampere. Okay, that is basically 50 ampere. And this angle is your theta 2. This is the angle of theta 2. Okay, so now I2 dash value 50 ampere you have, right? I0 value you have. So now what you have to do? You have to draw the resultant current, that is your this current. It is the value of I1. Okay. So that is nothing but the vector addition. So what I have to do now, I have to check the value of I2 dash and the value of I0. Okay, now I0 value, this is already known to you since it is lagging in nature. That's why minus sign is given. Okay, so minus angle is given, so minus 78.5 degrees. So now it is in polar form, you have to convert it into rectangular form. It is converted. Clear? Next, I2 dash, this value magnitude 50 is known. What is the angle? Angle is 31.8 degree. Okay, it is also lagging, so minus angle is present here. Clear? It is in polar form, so you need to convert it into the rectangular form. It is converted now. Okay, so what is the I1 value? I1 value is nothing but the sum of the no load current and this transformed current I2 dash. So I have to just add it. Okay, since they are already divided, they are already differentiated into real and imaginary coordinate. So now you add it. It is in rectangular form. So again convert it into polar form to get the magnitude. Okay. So magnitude is now here. So that is the value of the total primary current. Okay. Is that clear? Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And look, here this kind of this system is given where V is taken as reference. Okay. This diagram is partially correct. Okay. Because if you move this diagram, if you move this diagram like this, this is your V1. Okay. This is your I0, suppose, like this. So you will see that you are getting same vector diagram, but this one is correct. This one is the correct. Okay, what I taught you, what concept I gave you, based on that, try to solve the numericals. Okay, is there any other question? You can raise your question, no problem. And today, no attendance will be taken. Okay. This is only for your knowledge purpose so that you can perform well in exam. Okay. If you have any kind of question, any topic you need to discuss, you can say. Okay. Have you given already your attendances? Okay. Oh, already you have given. Very good. Okay, fine. So if you have any other question, you can discuss. No issue. Okay, so should I leave the meeting?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so all of you try your best to give your to complete your exam. Okay, and if there is any more numerical or any topic that you cannot understand, let me know. Okay. Okay, so thank you everyone. I am leaving the meeting. Thank you for attending.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.